Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. We are on Nifty daily time frame chart. As we can see that there was a huge fall yesterday in Nifty, and even today also there was a gap down opening, and market is just recovering now from that gap down opening. So in this situation, the first and foremost important thing for us would be to mark the important support levels for Nifty visible on the chart. So as marked with these red lines, first of all we shall see these horizontal supports. Now earlier we had this zone as a very strong resistance zone. So for the first time market came to this point, 10,130. There was a U-turn, and again for the second time it came there, and again there was a U-turn. Now after crossing this level, this zone acted as a continuous support. So prior resistance becoming support can now act as support also. So even this time also, this level can act as a good support for Nifty. So this is the horizontal support zone that we can draw on first hand. And the levels are 10,137 to 10,178. So you can just round them to the nearest figures. So these are the horizontal support zones for Nifty on first hand. Now secondly, when we connect the prior lows and extend it further, so this trend line support, we can call it as, when we are connecting the lows of all candles and extending it further to the right, we call it as a trend line support. So this trend line support is also at rescue for Nifty going forward. So this is the second support for Nifty. And thirdly, when we connect this tops, it acted as a trend line resistance in both of these situations. Now if I extend it further going forward, this trend line resistance will now act as a trend line support. So combining all these things, horizontal support zone, trend line support, and prior trend line resistance now acting as trend line support. So combining all these things, we can say that Nifty is now approaching a very strong support zone. So based on the simple resistance and support, we marked these levels. And based on this, what we have come to a conclusion that 10,137 is going to act as a very strong support for Nifty, if at all Nifty comes down to that level. So this complete zone is our strong support zone for Nifty. Now let's enable our indicators. So I hope you have marked these levels. Now I'm clearing these lines from the chart. We shall proceed with the indicators now. So I'm enabling my first indicator. Based on that, since I'm on a daily time frame chart, the pivot points visible to me are valid for a month. Now here the month of March has started. Now these pivot points are valid until March 31st. So based on this, the first level of support is again at 10,139. So even the indicator is also telling me the same. 10,137 was based on pure simple resistance and support. And now when I have enabled the pivot points, even the pivot point is also telling me the same thing. 10,139 is my first level of support because it is S1 of the pivot points. Now what are these pivot points? As we have seen in our revision lectures and normal class lectures, pivot points are based on a simple mathematical formula, and these monthly pivot points we get by using the high, low and close of prior month. When we input the high, low and close of prior month of February, we get some pivot points which are valid for the whole month of March. So based on that, 10,139 is my first level of support. This is our first indicator. Now going to our second indicator, which is simple moving average. Simple moving average is nothing but taking the average of close prices. Now when I'm inputting the 200 as my value, it means that I'm instructing the chart to take the close price of past 200 trading days. So take the close price of past 200 trading days and then give me an average price. Just taking the sum of all those 200 close prices and divide it by 200. I get a price. Every day I get a price like that. And in trading, most of the traders consider this 200 day moving average as a very good or a very strong indicator. And even this 200 day moving average is indicating the same. If you see here, it is around 10,130 now. So 10,137 is a very strong support based on simple resistance and support, based on pivot points, and also based on simple moving average. So when Nifty will try to come there, there are a higher number of chances that a good bounce back can be seen from that level. So on daily time frame, this is the complete story of Nifty based on resistance and support as well as pivots and moving averages. So just to repeat, the levels are 10,137 to 10,178. These are a very important support zone for Nifty going forward. Let me clear the chart and we shall move down to the lower time frame, which is hourly time frame. Now on hourly time frame, I'm going to enable my one more indicator, which is RSI. RSI is relative strength index. It tells you whether the movement in the price is justified or not. If price is making a new low every day, is that movement justified? Or if price is making a new high every day, is that justified? Is there any strength left in the price to follow the prior direction? So from this point, every day we could see that a new low is being made. So is there any strength left in the price to take it further down? Or is there going to be any U-turn? How do we say that? By using the divergences concept available in RSI. Now, what is a divergence? When the direction of RSI is not in alignment with the direction of price movement. So let me just connect the lows of the price and then I'll explain you clearly. So here I'm connecting the prior low with the current low. It is clearly visible that price had made a new low. Now if I connect the respective points of RSI also, even RSI should tell me the same thing. Even RSI also should make a new low. But here I can see that RSI is not making a new low. Instead, it is higher than the prior low. It means that whatever the new low is being made by the price, that is not having any strength. And at any point of time, there are possibilities that it might take a U-turn or a small upside is possible in Nifty as of now. So the point of discussion here is the movement in price in alignment with the movement in RSI? So as seen on the chart now, it is not in alignment. Now, the only thing what we need to do is wait for a confirmation on hourly chart. So we need a good green candle, which needs to close at least above 10,250. So if there is a good close above 10,250, the green candle, if it closes above this 10,250, a small upside is possible in Nifty. And what could be the target for that? 10,326 to 10,346. So I'm repeating it again. Movement in price is not in alignment with movement in RSI. So RSI is indicating that there are some certain possibilities that Nifty might take a U-turn and a small upside is possible. And for that decision, we are waiting for a confirmation. What is the confirmation? There needs to be a good green candle whose close must be above 10,250. On hourly time frame, if we get a candle which has its close above this 10,250, we can assume that, or we can see that Nifty is making a good up move at least until 10,330 to 10,346. Now, when will this become invalid? When RSI comes further down, and if it touches at least the prior low, or if it breaks the prior low and goes further down, then this setup will be invalid. Until then, we can wait for a green candle. And if at all RSI breaks its prior low, then this setup will be invalid. Now, this whole setup, what we call it as a bullish divergence, because RSI is showing bullishness and price is showing bearishness. So both the things are diverging from each other. One is showing bearishness and the other one is showing bullishness. So there is a divergence between both of them, and we go with the decision of RSI. Whatever RSI tells us, we take a trade in that direction, and RSI is telling that there is a bullish divergence as of now. And for the confirmation, we'll wait until a green candle closes above 10,250. And if at all RSI breaks its prior low here, then these setups become invalid. Now let's go to further lower time frame, or let's enable our pivot points here, even on hourly time frame also, and let's see what it is saying. So it is approaching S3 of this week. Whenever we are on hourly time frame, the pivot points displayed to us are valid for a week. Now, since we are already on Wednesday, these pivot points are valid for Thursday and Friday. Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. So this S3 is the next level of support for Nifty as far as the pivot points are considered. And even here also, it is somewhere around 10,143. And on daily time frame, we marked 10,137 as our support level. So this is based on pivot points on hourly time frame. It is saying that 10,143 is the next level of support. I'm going down to lower time frame, which is 15 minute. So on 15 minute, we don't have any divergences as of now. So no confirmation from RSI side. The only thing what we can see here is the pivot points. So pivot points, it already opened below the central pivot point. The zone above central pivot point, we call it as bullish zone, and the zone below central pivot point, we call it as a bearish zone. It is now trading in between this central pivot point and S1, exactly at the midpoint. It is trading at that zone. So in intraday time frame, it is slightly bearish, and even if it makes an up move, chances are that it can come until 10,300, or at least until prior resistance, which is 10,323, which is the same zone which we have marked on hourly time frame also, based on the RSI bullish divergence. So what I want to say here is, if at all Nifty makes an up move, this zone will act as a strong resistance, 10,300 to 10,323. And if it continues its down move, this intraday S1 will act as a strong support, 10,163. And since we are on 15 minute time frame, the pivot points displayed to us are valid only for a day, that is today. Now today's pivot points, they are constructed by taking the high, low and close of yesterday. And in this process, you can see that today's S1 is in confluence with yesterday's S3. So this 10,163 is having a good importance. So this zone is having a good importance, 10,163, as far as Nifty intraday chart is considered. So I'm just repeating what we can see in Nifty on 15 minute time frame. If Nifty turns back from here, 10,300 to 10,323 is the strong resistance zone, and if it continues its fall, this 10,163 will act as a strong support because it is intraday S1 and it is in confluence with yesterday's S3. So this is the complete story of Nifty. On daily time frame, 10,137 to 10,178 are the important resistance levels, are the important support levels. And on hourly time frame, we saw a bullish divergence, and we also saw that a small upside is possible. And for that, we have marked 10,300 to 10,330 as the important resistance zone. Even on intraday time frame also, we saw the same. If Nifty takes a U-turn from here, 10,300 to 10,323 is our first level of resistance. And on the downside, this 10,163 will act as a strong support. So this is the complete story of Nifty for the day. Let's move to our next index, which is Bank Nifty. Now for Bank Nifty, on daily time frame, the visible important support level would be 23,858 to 23,939. A reason being, earlier it had acted as a strong resistance, and going forward, the same level, the prior resistance, it acted as support. Now, even now also, we can expect the same. So prior support will come to the rescue of Bank Nifty even now. This is what we can expect from Bank Nifty. This is a falling channel, and Bank Nifty is respecting the channel. Every time it is going up, it is coming down, and every time it is coming down, it is going up. And you can see that yesterday we had a break of that channel, indicating further bearishness in Bank Nifty. Not only this, if I enable my indicator, which is 200 day moving average, Bank Nifty closed below this 200 day moving average yesterday itself. So that is also indicating further bearishness in Bank Nifty. So two important things we discussed. First is the important level of support. If at all Bank Nifty falls further, the important levels which are marked as support for Bank Nifty would be 23,858 to 23,939. Remember that whenever we mark supports or resistances, we cannot mark them as a single line. They always needs to be marked as a zone. This was the first important point. And secondly, we used our 200 day moving average, and we saw that Bank Nifty closed below this 200 day moving average yesterday itself. And thirdly, we saw that there is a falling channel which Bank Nifty respected till now, and yesterday's close was below this falling channel, so which is also indicating further bearishness. And as indicated, today we saw a gap down opening in Bank Nifty. So horizontal support, 200 day moving average, and falling channel. Let's go to our other indicators and see. And before that, I'm clearing the chart. Based on the pivot points, we have this 24037 as our first level of support. Now, as everybody guessed, since we are on daily time frame chart, the pivot point here would be valid for a month. Now this S1, it started from March 1st and then it will continue until March 31st. So based on that, this S1, 24065, this is our first level of support for Bank Nifty based on the classical pivot points. On based on simple resistance, simple support also, we saw that 23,939 was the first level of support for Bank Nifty. Now even this indicator is also very much near to that, just 100 points of difference between both of them. So indicator is also telling us the same thing. Now we have enabled our next indicator, which is RSI. We enable RSI to search only for divergences. Nothing about this overbought and oversold. We'll only search for divergences if we enable the RSI. And I can see that as of now, there is no divergence. This is the lowest low in RSI that I can see. And the value of that is 31.96. And at present, it is 31.24. So current level of RSI has already broken the prior low. So there is no bullish divergence as of now. So no use of RSI on daily time frame. So we came to a conclusion on daily time frame for Bank Nifty. 23,858 to 23,939. These are the important levels of support based on horizontal support level. And based on the indicator, 24,065 is the next level of support for Bank Nifty. It has already closed below 200-day moving average as well as the falling channel. Both of them are indicating further bearishness. And if Bank Nifty falls, we have this important support level at rescue for Bank Nifty. Now let's move down to our lower time frame, which is hourly. And we'll enable our first indicator on hourly, which is pivot points. So based on pivot points, since we are on hourly time frame chart, these pivot points are valid for a week. So it started from Monday and these pivot points will last until this Friday. We can clearly see that during the first hour, there is a bounce back from the pivot point. It tried to close below the pivot point level, but it did not. There was a good bounce back in the price level. And now it is trying to close this gap. We had a gap down opening today. So this second green candle is now trying to close that gap. So as observed, these pivot levels play an important role in everyday's trading. So I'm marking this as my next level of support for Bank Nifty. Then the value of that would be 24,291. This is the first level of support for Bank Nifty on hourly time frame. And secondly, I'll enable my RSI to see if there are any bullish divergences. Now, the prior low for me would be this. And the value of RSI here is 24.27. And here, it is 23.04. So RSI did not close below prior low, whereas price closed below the prior low. So there is a bullish divergence here. And if there is a good green candle, we can expect Bank Nifty to go at least until 24,600 by the end of this week. So let me mark this bullish divergence first. So price made a lower low. And I'm zooming a bit for this RSI. Whereas RSI made a higher low. So the value here is 24.27 and it is 23.04. Oh, I think RSI has broken the prior low, so there is no bullish divergence here. So there is no confirmation from RSI side. Only pivot points is indicating as the good level of support. So RSI broke prior low. So there is no bullish divergence here. So on hourly time frame, this is the only story available to us. Price approaching the next level of support, which is S2. Only thing is, if we zoom out the chart a bit, then we are able to find the divergence here. From this low it is. From this low to this low, price made a lower low, whereas Bank Nifty made a higher low. This we can observe at this point, only if we zoom out a bit. We have connected the lows from Feb 6th, that is yesterday's trading session, Feb 6th session. From there, we have connected to current session. So we can see a bullish divergence on hourly time frame if we zoom out a bit. And we need to see if this plays out its role on this hourly chart. All we need is a good green candle, which needs to close above today's opening candle's high. And the high made was 24,371. So we need a green candle, which needs to close above 24,371. Then we can expect a small up move in Bank Nifty. We cannot say that a bullish run is going to start, because the main trend is bearish. In this bearish trend, we cannot expect any stock to turn all of a sudden. Only thing is, we can expect small up moves. One such example is visible live on the chart. If I connect that low with this low here, and the same, if I connect the same with the RSI also, if I do the same with RSI, price made a lower low here, whereas RSI made a higher low. And you can see the small up move made by Bank Nifty. There was a green candle immediately after this bullish divergence, and from 24,728, price went until 25,000. At least 300 points of move we could see in Bank Nifty. So the same I'm expecting even now. Only thing is, I need a green candle to close above the first 1 hour session's high. What is that high? 24,371. If this green candle closes above this price level, I expect Bank Nifty to go at least until S1, which is 24,598. So this is the story on hourly time frame. Only just to revise it, price has approached pivot point S2, and based on RSI, we zoomed out the chart a bit, and then we could find a RSI bullish divergence even on Bank Nifty. So let me remove the drawings and move down to the lower time frame. So on lower time frame, price is approaching the pivot point S1. 24,193. This is the first level of support for Bank Nifty on 15 minute time frame. And even if we zoom out, do we have any bullish divergences? So this is the same bullish divergence we saw on hourly time frame from Feb 6th to current price level. So no need of marking that. We have done it already on the hourly time frame. So in 15 minutes, there's nothing much to discuss in Bank Nifty. Only on hourly chart and daily time frame chart, we have certain signals for Bank Nifty. So this is it for Nifty and Bank Nifty today. I hope you have recorded all those levels mentioned. Thank you all for joining.